This video is about helping your child who has dyslexia and is in year 4 to 7 with their reading. Now, if you have a child from year 4 to 7 who's really struggling with their reading, it's absolutely vital you uncover why that is. And if you now know it's because of dyslexia, great, put into place the changes that need to be made. But if you're not sure what's going on, you really need to go and get some extra professional help to find out why they're not reading and what we can do about that. Someone famous once said that the definition of insanity is to keep trying to do something that hasn't been working, expecting a different result. Let's not do that. Let's try something new. Let's see what we can do to make things work. Parents always give credit to their children for their successes, but when their children are struggling, we own that and we blame ourselves. Your child is not struggling because you're a bad parent. If your child is not reading well, it's not because your child is stupid. A lot of children blame themselves and they think, I can't read well because I'm stupid. The truth is you just haven't found what works yet. Don't let your child just declare that I'm stupid, so I can't read, because then they're not going to be motivated to try. And we need to keep in mind that if your child is in year 4 to 7, then they will avoid doing reading if they feel stupid at it, and they'll go and do something that they feel good at, like playing computer games. It's normal, but as parents, we need to be leaders here and we need to cause your child to read. It's really common that a parent will feel frustrated with their child when they're not able to read. That frustration and that anger, I guess, at just, why is my child not reading? And when we're like that, and when our child picks up on that, they don't want to read to us, they don't feel safe, and they feel like even more of a failure. So it's important that we don't express those feelings to our child, or if we have expressed those feelings to our child in the past, we need to own that, and we need to face up to it and go, you know what? I know that in the past I've been like this, I was wrong. Will you forgive me? And get on with life. A child who's in year 4, 5, 6, or 7 probably doesn't want to read a story that's about a bear that went to the beach. You might need to go with your child to a bookshop or a library and get some books that they're going to find quite interesting. A good place to start can be comic books if the text is large enough and if the writing's not too stylized. Children love to read comic books. Andy Griffiths has done the world a big favour by writing some of the books he's written. A lot of his books have small font, but then there's a lot of other books he's written that have larger font, and they're fun stories for older kids to read. They're nice and silly, and they're a great read. It's often really important to get a child who has dyslexia to read more slowly. What happens is that often they'll decide, oh, I need to read faster. And the faster they try to read, the more errors they make and the more frustrated they feel. We need to get our children to slow their reading down. And remember, look for books where the font is a little bit larger and preferably bold. It just makes it easier for a child with dyslexia to keep track of where those words are. It's important to use reward and consequence well to cause our child to read. We need to keep in mind that reading is exhausting for your child, so reward it well. Reward it with extra time in front of the PlayStation or the TV. Reward it with chocolates. Reward it with pocket money. Whatever the reward needs to be, whatever it takes to have our child starting to read. At the same time, not all children are motivated by rewards, and some of them are going to need a consequence. So the consequence for not reading could be the TV goes off for the night, or the PlayStation is put away, or loss of pocket money. A good one that I've seen work well for people is to have the internet be turned off for 24 hours. Whatever it takes to get our child to read, we need to do it. Have your child read for short periods of time. There's nothing gained by having your child read for 30 minutes. They're better off reading for 2 sessions of 8 or 10 minutes at a time. Once you push your child beyond what their concentration can sustain, they're not learning anyway. They're just going to develop a negative attitude, and it's going to be harder for you tomorrow to persuade them to read. Keep the reading to short bursts of reading. A child in year 4, 5, 6, or 7 really should be reading for maybe 7 to 10 minutes at a time, no longer than that. If they're reading any longer than that, then they're not actually getting much value out of it. They're just getting exhausted by it. It's important to look at what you can change to help your child. There's another video that basically lists out all the things that you should change. Things like keep away from fluorescent lights, not good for a child who has dyslexia, makes the words move even more. Things like change the background color of the page they're reading from. Purple and blue tend to be pretty good. If purple and blue don't help your child, then try pink or try gray. If those colors don't work, we'll keep searching. There's almost always a color that your child will find it easier to read from than the color white. White is a terrible color for children who have dyslexia. Remember to choose books that have a bit of space between the lines. Unless your child has a really severe disability, they can learn to read. It's just a matter of changing a few things, making life a bit easier, and approaching it in the right way. Your child can make progress as long as they don't give up on themselves and as long as you help them with a few key things. Get the basics right, implement as much of what I've shown you as you can, and if you're still having trouble, have a chat with your child's teacher, see what they suggest. It's really important that your child learns to read, because until they read well, they will not write well. So reading is number one priority right here. Go for it.